Shortcuts automations in macOS Tahoe completely changed the game. I'm going to show you how you can drag any file onto your desktop and immediately get a summary and add it to an Apple Note. Transcribe any audio file that hits your downloads folder. Get your MacBook's battery percentage in an iPhone notification. Automatically sort files as soon as they hit your desktop. Plus automations for when you connect an external drive, connecting external displays, opening an app, and more. So to set up any of these automations, you need to go to the new Automations tab here in Shortcuts on your Mac. Here's where you can create new automations with lots of different triggers, and we're going to go over a bunch. And one of the most powerful triggers right here is watching a folder. When you create an automation with this, it can watch any folder that you choose. Let's make this the desktop, somewhere where we drop lots of files. You can choose when any file or item is added, modified, or removed. I'm going to choose added, and I want this automation to run immediately. I'm going to leave this off, notify when run, so I don't get a bunch of notifications, and let's click next. And here's where you can choose the shortcuts that you can download in the video description to run these automations. Now, whenever we do these folder automations in macOS Tahoe, we can use the shortcut input, so this way that file will get passed into the shortcut, and then we need to add two actions. Get contents of shortcut input, because it's actually passing the folder name, and then I'm using the filter files action. Once you drag that after the get contents of folder, I filter it by date modified, get the latest first or the newest file, and I limit it to just one. I find the get item from list action, and if you have any other settings here, it can make the shortcut error out. But you could download this exact shortcut at the link in the description. Now this first automation is either going to summarize a document we drop on the desktop or transcribe and summarize an audio or video file. Now I set up an if statement, so if the file ends with PDF or .doc, it's going to get the text from that input. Otherwise, it's going to transcribe it. Depending on what kind of files you drop on your desktop, you might want to adjust these file extensions and this if statement. But now let's set this up in a folder automation. I'll go to the Automations tab, click the plus icon. We're going to choose Folder. Let's choose our desktop folder. When files are added, run immediately, don't notify. And then I'll choose my AI transcribe and summary shortcut that we were just working on. And that's it. Ready to go. So now I'm going to drop an audio file onto my desktop. This is a Primary Tech Daily episode. That's my tech podcast. Subscribe below. Now that I pasted that MP3 file, the shortcut is silently working in the background. It's going to transcribe it because it's an audio file. And just like that, an Apple note was created. It has a title for the note, a summary of that audio file, and the key points in a bulleted list. Plus, I made this so the Apple note also gets the full transcript underneath that. And what's great is that transcribe action on macOS Tahoe can transcribe even hours-long audio. And I'll show you how to use that with full-length podcasts in a minute. And because it has that if statement, it'll also work with PDFs or Word documents. So I'm going to drop this PDF onto my desktop. And that shortcut again is going to run in the background, do the same thing, get summary key points, and pull all the text in plain text, which is great if you want to search through your Apple Notes. It'll pull these results, and it's going to create that Apple Note in just a few seconds. And here it is, summary, key takeaways, and all the text from that document here in the Apple Note. Now remember, this shortcut is going to run anytime a new file hits your desktop. So if you want to create a specific folder where you're going to drop certain things, it could be on your desktop or maybe on your downloads folder. You could call it something like automation, and then choose that folder for the shortcut input. Number two, you can get notified on your iPhone when your MacBook battery drops below or rises above a certain battery percentage. I'm going to create a new automation here, and if you scroll down, you'll see battery level is an option. I'll tap next, and I'm going to say when it rises above, and I can type in a specific percentage, we'll say 83%. I want this to run immediately, hit next, and now this next part, this is going to show a notification on your Mac, but with the Pushcuts app on your iPhone, I can get the notification here. So on your iPhone, let's go to the Pushcuts app, and this is super easy to set up. Pushcuts is also free for your first three notifications, and then you have to pay if you want more than three. You can see I have a number of them. I'm going to create a new notification. We'll call it MacBook Air 83%. I'm going to put that in the notification title as well. That's all I really need to customize. Then once you hit that blue check, you can copy the URL down here. Copy that, copy the URL, and thanks to Universal Clipboard, I can just paste it here on my Mac, and we just need one action, get contents of URL. I'll choose that, paste the URL I got from Pushcuts, and that's it. I'm going to get a Pushcut notification when my MacBook rises above a certain battery percentage. All right, I just hit 84%, and sure enough, if I look on my iPhone, I have a notification from Pushcut, and there it says MacBook Air 83%. This is great because you can also set one for when it falls below a certain percentage, and even if you're not actively using your MacBook, but you want to know when it gets below 50%, this way you can charge it for the next day, you can choose falls below 50%, run immediately, and then just add that get contents URL action and paste your push cut URL. Next, we can use that transcribe action to get a summary and download of our favorite podcast every morning without having to do anything. I'll put a link to download this shortcut in the description, but put the RSS feed of your favorite podcast here at the top. Primary Technology, it's a great one to use. This is going to download the podcast MP3 file. It's going to pull the different information like the publish date, the title of the episode, and more. Now, for a lot of these summarize actions, I'm using the Apple Intelligence Use Model action, so you don't need to have ChatGPT installed. But I'm using the ChatGPT extension because the private cloud compute and on-device models will sometimes error out on longer transcripts. So it's just safer to use that ChatGPT extension. Now let's run this shortcut and see if it works. This should get the latest episode from that RSS feed. You will have to allow it the first time, and then this should be able to run automatically behind the scenes. It's going to transcribe that MP3 file, summarize it, and put all of that into an Apple Note. Also, like in macOS Tahoe, you can see the shortcut progress in the menu bar, and it's already done. There's the title of the episode from the RSS feed, the publish date, then you have the summary, key points underneath that, and then the full transcript. Now, if you want, you can also add the MP3 file to the bottom of this note if you would like. It's going to start taking up iCloud space and storage space, but you can do that too. Now, if it's a daily show like that, you can wake up to that Apple note already there for you. Just go to the automation tab again here in macOS Tahoe. We're going to do a time of day automation. We can choose every day at sunrise. We want this to run immediately. Hit next. And then just run that shortcut you downloaded down in the video description. There's that Primary Tech Daily download, although you do have to support the show for that. So I'll just put our main show RSS feed for the shortcut. Tap done. And now every morning at sunrise, that shortcut is going to run in the background and you can wake up to an Apple note with the transcription, summary, and all of that ready to read. Next, you can now use Shortcuts Automations to automatically move files that drop in one folder to another. This is really useful, especially if you have something like a Plex server. So I'm going to connect to my Plex server here, and now we can create a new automation. Let's tap plus. This is going to be a folder automation again. Let's choose the folder, and we'll do the downloads folder once again. When any item is added to the folder, we want this to run immediately. Hit next, and now let's create a new shortcut. So we're going to get the contents of folder and choose the shortcut input because it's the folder that's being sent through the automation. And then I'm going to add a repeat command in case we drop multiple files. I'll do a repeat with each, so it's going to do this with every new file I add to that folder, even if it's multiple. And I'm going to use a move file command, and so we want to move that repeat item to, and then I can click here and then choose any folder I want, including my NAS. I'm actually going to create a new folder called Shortcuts so we can see exactly what's moving there. I'll click open, and that's it. Now, whenever I drop any kind of file to my downloads folder, it's going to move it to my network attached storage. Now, you can add that if statement if you want to just move certain files, maybe like video files. I'm going to call this move files to NAS. So here's my NAS new shortcuts folder, and here's the downloads folder that I'm going to drop something into. Let's just take that PDF we were working with before. I'll put it in my downloads folder. That shortcut's going to get triggered to run automatically. And just like that, it moved the file to the shortcuts folder on my network attached storage. Now, I have some fancy automations that I actually can't share here on YouTube, but I'll put the full length video on how I explain what I'm doing over in my shortcuts community. So join at create.beard.fm, and this is gonna be for paid members only. Over 500 of you have become paying members, and you get shortcuts requests, access to my shortcuts GPT, you can search my shortcuts database, and a ton more. And I'm gonna be doing more live streams when you support the community. But this video, I'm going to walk through my entire Rube Goldberg machine on how I move and download files. So be sure to join the community. I'm going to put the video I'm talking about in my Shortcuts of the Week, and you can see how you can use this kind of automation to very powerful effect. Some other new triggers available on the Mac are external drive and external display. So we can create an automation that says when an external drive is connected. I'll click next. You can say any external drive or a specific external drive, like one you might edit from Final Cut. We'll say when it is connected. You can also say when it's disconnected. We want this to run immediately. Tap next, and let's create a new shortcut. Maybe we simply just want to open an app that could be Disk Utility. I'll search for Disk Utility here, and that's it. Now, whenever I connect an external drive, Disk Utility is going to automatically open. I actually don't have any more ports on my MacBook Air, so I'm going to connect this to the Studio Display, which my MacBook Air is connected to. External drive has been connected. We should see it here pop up in the Finder window. And that quickly, Disk Utility just opened up. I actually edit in Final Cut off external SSDs exclusively, so I can program this to open Final Cut whenever I connect an SSD or a specific one. And next, we can create an automation for when an external display connects. So let me scroll down. I'll choose when my display connects. I'll tap next. I'll say is connected, run this immediately. And let's create a new shortcut. And maybe we want specific apps to open in split view when we connect our display. Split screen apps is actually an action on macOS. And so I'm just gonna add one action here. Split screen between, let's say podcasts and we'll say Safari. You can choose the ratio here in the action and that's it. So I just disconnected my studio display from my MacBook Air. And now I'm going to reconnect it, which should trigger that shortcut. And it did open those apps and put them in split screen, but it's over here on my MacBook. Your mileage may vary, but the automation worked. Next, we can trigger automations just by opening an app. Let's scroll down in the automations window. We'll choose app. And let's say when an app is open. One I use to record primary technology is Audio Hijack. So I'll say when that's opened, we want this to run immediately. And now you can do a bunch of fancy things, but let's just set a focus mode. I'll choose set focus and we'll turn filming on. That's my focus mode for filming and podcasting. Now you can say until it's turned off, until you leave, or we can get a little fancy here. And if the podcast is scheduled in my calendar, I could say get any calendar events that are in the next, we'll say 1 hour. I can filter by calendar. So just my recording schedule calendar. Then I can change the focus action to keep this focus on until the event ends. And the event in question can be that event that's on my recording schedule calendar that's starting in the next hour. Now with that automation set, I'll go up here to Control Center. You'll see I have no focus mode on right now. And now let's open Audio Hijack from Spotlight. And now that the app opened, I'll look in Control Center and sure enough, my filming focus mode is on. You can also trigger that automation to open certain links, like maybe you have a Riverside link in your next calendar event that can open in a different browser. Possibilities are endless. All right, for these last few, let's get even more advanced. We can create an automation now specifically for email. I'll tap next, and now I can say any sender or a specific sender. I'm gonna specify when I get an email from podcast@primarytech.fm. I'll leave the subject blank, so any subject. I can choose what mail account connected to my Mac this is gonna trigger. I'll choose my Fastmail account. I'll say any recipient, and then I want this to run immediately. I'll tap next, and let's create a new shortcut so you can see this from scratch, but it's gonna receive emails as input. Well, I'm gonna look for the use model action for Apple Intelligence. Again, I'm gonna use the ChatGPT extension because it doesn't error out on longer text. And all I'm gonna say is summarize the following attachment. And now I'm gonna two-finger click, insert the variable, which is the shortcut input, and here's where it gets wild. I can click shortcut input, and then choose what part of the email I want to pass to that Apple Intelligence action. And I can even choose attachments. And then I'm just going to add a quick look action, but you can customize this to create an Apple note, create a PDF file, then move that attachment somewhere. You can do a ton of stuff. But now whenever I get an email from a specific email address that has an attachment, I'm going to get a summary of that attachment immediately without me having to do anything. All right, now that that automation's created, so I'm going to attach a PDF to this email, send it to myself, and once it hits my inbox, the automation will be triggered. That shortcut should start running in the background. And just like that, a quick view summary popped up. This is the model response. The PDF was about features in iOS 26. And now I can see what that attachment was about without even opening the email or the attachment. Then you can add things like create notes with the attachment and the summary connected. Number 9, we can automatically sort our files even if they get dropped in bulk. Now you can use an Apple Intelligence action, and I walked through this in a previous video, I'll link above, but let's do a quick auto sort. We'll again have this watch a folder. We'll select our downloads folder. When any item is added, run immediately. We'll tap next. Let's create a new shortcut. Remember, we need to start with the get contents of folder, and we're gonna choose the shortcut input as the get contents of, and then let's do a repeat with each. Then for every file it checks, let's do some if statements. So if, let's do file extension is MP3, then let's move that file, and repeat item is that file. Well, I'm gonna move that to my audio folder. I can delete the otherwise. Let's add another if statement. If that file extension is MOV, and remember to select repeat item in the subsequent if statements. Well, I'm gonna move it to my renders folder. Now you can keep adding if statements for different file extensions, name types, or even ask Apple Intelligence to look at the contents of the file. But right now, if I drop MP3 and movie files, it's gonna move them to my audio and render folders automatically. So I'm gonna open these two windows. This is that audio folder I selected. This is the renders folder. I'll finish titling this shortcut automation. And now let's see what happens when I drop some files into my downloads folder. I'll choose an MP3 file and an MP4 file. I changed the if statement in case you were wondering. I'll paste these to my downloads folder. That shortcut will be triggered, run in the background, and just like that, you'll see my files moved over to the specific folders that I put in the shortcut. And so that means you can auto sort file types, contents of files, and a ton more. And for number 10, let's do one more easy automation. I'll click the plus icon, and you can also select when you connect to Wi-Fi or connect and disconnect to Bluetooth devices. So maybe you want when you connect to your home Wi-Fi network that your home focus mode is enabled. Well, I'm going to choose my home network here, Minas Tirith. I'll say when it's joined or when it's disconnected. Choose whether or not to run after a connection interruption. We want this to run immediately. And again, we can choose to just set a focus mode. So I'll do a new shortcut. We'll do set a focus mode. Turn on your focus mode to mute all those work notifications. And now when you connect to your home Wi-Fi network on your MacBook, your focus mode will automatically turn on. So I hope that inspired you. The possibilities go way beyond this, and I'm going to do even more advanced shortcuts really soon. So get subscribed to the channel. If you have questions, leave comments below this video or shortcuts requests. And if you want to make sure that I see your shortcuts request, join my shortcuts community at create.beard.fm. When you support with that $5 a month or $50 a year, I have that priority shortcuts request space, and I make sure to answer every single one. Sometimes I can't build it. Some actions just don't exist, but I answer everyone and I try to build them and then feature in future videos. And if you want to see that Rube Goldberg machine that I was talking about that can do stuff with internet videos and other stuff I can't talk about on YouTube, well, that's going to be in the shortcut of the week. I'll pin it to the top so you won't miss it. And again, that's create.beard.fm. I'll put a couple videos up here, especially some Apple Intelligence shortcuts, not just automations that I built recently, and my macOS Tahoe review, which talks about Spotlight, Control Center, and a ton more. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.